The topic of today's clinical presentation is gynecological examination. The learning objectives of today's session are: students should be able to describe the steps of gynecological examination, and students should be able to perform gynecological examination. Pelvic examination is the part of the assessment of the female patients presenting with different gynecological problems. A pelvic examination is an examination of the internal and external reproductive organs, including vagina, vulva, uterus, cervix, ovaries, and fallopian tubes. First of all, we will discuss the preparation for the gynecological examination. The first step is you will introduce yourself to the patient, take the consent for examination from the patient, explain the need and procedure of the examination to the patient, ask her to empty her bladder, ensure privacy, request a chaperone, especially for the male doctors. Adequate light and equipment should be adequate. First of all, after fulfilling the prerequisites which we have discussed, you will ask the patient to remove the clothing from the waist down, and any sanitary protection, if present, it should be removed. Cover the patient with the sheet when appropriate. When ready, ask the patient to lie down on the couch on their back with knees bent and apart. This is the dorsal position. So the examination can be performed in the dorsal position and in the lithotomy position. In this patient, the patient will lie on the couch with knees bent and they are apart. So first step of examination is the inspection. The figure which is present in this slide, it is showing you the different external genital organs. First of all, put on the gloves and inspect the external genitalia. Following things are looked for: any deficiency associated with childbirth, hair distribution, skin abnormalities like any lesion, warts, erythema, any discharge. If discharge is present, its color, its consistency, its smell, any sign of bleeding, any swelling of the vulva, any tumor, cyst, especially Bartholin or sebaceous cyst. It is usually found at the external genital area. Ask the patient to cough to observe any incontinence or prolapse. Palpate the labia majora with the index finger and the thumb to find out any swelling or lump in it. The next step is the speculum examination. A speculum is a device which is used to look inside the vagina and observe the vaginal walls and the cervix. Different type of speculums which are used, these are the sim speculum, which is shown in the figure B, and Cusco speculum, which is shown in the figure A. So the most of the time, the speculum which is used in the gynecological examination in our outdoors is Cusco speculum. You can see in the figure A, metallic Cusco speculum. So the steps of speculum examination. First of all, lubricate the speculum. Part the labia using your left hand, as it is shown in the figure, which is with the mannequin. Gently insert the speculum with your right hand. Fully insert the speculum with screw facing sideways and the blades vertical. Rotate 90 degree during insertion so the screw faces upwards and the blades become horizontal. Slowly opens the plate and use light to inspect the cervix. As the Cusco speculum is a self-retaining speculum, so you can tighten the screw to hold open the speculum. Once the speculum blades are opened, you can visualize the cervix, which is shown in the figure 3. And the vaginal walls are also seen. You can inspect for any abnormal discharge, erosion, ulceration, growth, polyp, any inflammation and bleeding. The third step of gynecological examination is the bimanual examination. The bimanual examination is performed by using your two hands. First of all, use lubricating gel to lubricate the right index finger and the middle finger. So we can use the middle finger and the index finger of our right hand. Separate the labia with the two fingers of the abdominal hand and insert the tips of the fingers. Move along the posterior wall of the vagina and locate the cervix. Once cervix is felt, look for it and feel for its smoothness, clots, any mobility and firmness. Place the fingers in the posterior fornix to lift the uterus while simultaneously pushing the fundus down by placing the left hand above the pubic symphysis. Palpate the uterus and check for its size, shape, location, consistency, mobility and tenderness. Locate ovaries laterally on the sides of the uterus and determine size and consistency. Check the size, shape, consistency, mobility, tenderness or any mass in the adenexa. Once the examination is complete, thank the patient and allow them to get dressed in private. Dispose of your gloves and wash your hands. Once the patient is dressed, you can summarize the findings and suggest further investigations. Thank you.